The RG35XX is the latest handheld in Ambinex XX lineup, and probably the one that everybody has been waiting for. It's a fantastic homage to the original Game Boy Advance SP, which offers so much more than just Game Boy Advance gaming. But does it offer anything truly new to the XX lineup, and can it potentially take the place of the original Game Boy Advance with all the extra gaming experiences it offers? I've been using the RG35XX SP exclusively as my number one console for the past week to answer these questions, and this is what happened. The first thing I noticed when I got my 35XX SP is just how stunning this console looks. I'm blown away with the attention to detail and accuracy of how much it looks like the original Game Boy Advance SP. This isn't the first clamshell design emulation handheld based off the GBA SP look. The PowerKitty V90 was the first one I was aware of. Whereas the PowerKitty V90 had an overall similarity, the RG35XX SP looks like it has been made in the same factory with the same materials as the original Game Boy Advance SP. With the exception of essential modern updates like extra buttons, input ports, and improved screen to support emulation needs, the 35XX looks and feels identical to the original SP. It genuinely feels like Nintendo made it. The first game I decided to fire up obviously had to be a GBA classic. Coincidentally, the retro refresh game of the month was Golden Sun, so I was good to go. I'd originally started playing Golden Sun during the 30-day Game Boy Advance Challenge, a game I absolutely loved but didn't manage to complete. Starting again on the 35XX SP felt just as natural as playing it on the Game Boy Advance. So good in fact that I totally forgot to use save states, instead opting for the traditional save functionality of the game, something I never normally do on an emulation handheld. Talking about save states, the nice thing about the 35XX SP is that because I got it from GoGameGeek, it actually came with a decent SD card, meaning I don't have to worry about my save states getting randomly corrupted as much. Usually these devices come with SD cards that you need to replace straight away, otherwise they'll fail, but GoGameGeek seem to have stepped up to the challenge of including a good SD card with their consoles. Playing Golden Sun was such a brilliant experience, and as the first day came to an end, I decided to test the sleep functionality of the 35XX SP. Closing the original SP didn't provide any real sleep mode. True sleep mode that saved your battery when you closed the lid came in the DS. However, the 35XX is a modern console, so I hope that it would benefit from similar functionality, especially as it is a clamshell design. The screen seemed to turn off, however, the green power light stayed on, so things didn't seem too promising. The next day, I grabbed the 35XX SP, and unfortunately, the battery was fully drained. After recharging the SP and playing around with it a bit more, I realized that it does actually have a decent sleep mode. You just need to press the power button first, as opposed to just closing the screen. Once I figured this out, the proper way to use sleep mode, it turned out to be really good and actually managed to keep me on one charge of battery for the whole week. Next up, I decided to try some PS1 games. Although on the smaller end, I've always found XX consoles to be great for PS1 gaming. I scrolled through the preloaded PS1 games and came across Need for Speed 3, one of my favorites from back in the day. I loaded it up with the standard built-in PS1 emulator, but everything was really slow and totally unplayable. This is really weird, as the hardware should blitz PS1 emulation, so I decided to jump over to RetroArch, a nice addition to the XX console since the 35XX Plus, and it was much better, running at full speed like I expected. Continuing on with the racing theme, and over the weekend I had the annual Le Mans 24-hour race playing throughout the house. Le Mans is such a unique spectacle and unlike any other race out there. My kids really got into it this year, choosing Ferrari as their favourite team. While we watched, I had such an urge to play the classic PS1 Le Mans game. I played it quite a bit last year on the Retro Pocket 3 Plus, but wanted to try it on the 35XX SP instead. I downloaded a copy and started it up on the standard PS1 emulator. And once again, things didn't run very well, with the game getting stuck on the loading screen. Jumping over to RetroArch again, I thought would solve my issues, but not this time. Instead, the game kept crashing. I'm not exactly sure what was to blame here, as I do know I've had this running on other devices. But in all honesty, I couldn't be bothered trying to figure it out, so I just moved on. Having played a lot of racing games recently, I felt like a change of pace. So I jumped back into the GBA library and came across a game I loved on the PS2, but never played the Game Boy Advance version, Baldur's Gate. What a great version on the Game Boy Advance too. It's honestly a lot more like the PS2 version than I imagined. The funny thing is though, I'm not even really looking at these Game Boy Advance games from the perspective of how well is it emulated. The 35XX SP does such a great job playing Game Boy Advance games that I'm just approaching them from the perspective of how much do I enjoy the game. It honestly feels like I'm back in the 30-day Game Boy Advance Challenge. The only difference is the overwhelming choice of games to choose from that we are used to now from retro emulation handhelds. I've also been really craving playing some golf games recently, so I decided to load Everybody's Golf on the PS1, or Hotshots Golf as it's also known. But I also wanted to load Mario Golf Advanced Tour. Starting with Everybody's Golf, and this worked brilliantly, even on the standard PS1 emulator. Such a fantastic game that still stands up to this day and even outshines some modern golf games. I did face some difficulty though trying to play when I was outside. The last few days have been blisteringly hot with bright sunshine. Trying to play Everybody's Golf against the sun glare, even with a brightness up at 5, was really difficult. Although I think this is more of a game graphics issue because the 35 XXP menus were clearly visible. Around this time, a new console also arrived in the post. One I've been waiting some time for, and one that will be my next 30-day challenge. I was so tempted to jump straight into the challenge because I've been waiting for this console for ages, but I'm enjoying the 35X XSP so much, I was happy to wait it out. If you want to know what that console is, keep an eye out for the next 30-day challenge. Anyway, back to the 35X XSP, and I was struggling to play Everybody's Golf whenever I was sat outside. And with the weather being so good, I didn't want to stay in, so I decided to try Mario Golf Advanced Tour instead. Up until now, I've always used the standard GBA emulator and it's been flawless. But that was before I tried Mario Golf. The game started okay, but then got stuck on the loading screen. Once again, I decided to jump over to RetroArch and things worked flawlessly, with the game fully visible even in the bright sunlight. What's even better is that RetroArch is already set up with an absolutely gorgeous filter that makes the screen look even more like an original GBA SP. I didn't think things could get more authentic, but they just did. On previous XX consoles, RetroArch has had a few issues. For example, the controls weren't set up correctly when playing certain games like Colin McRae 2. However, on the 35XX SP, things seem to have been improved significantly, with pretty much all games working brilliantly when in RetroArch. I'll definitely be using RetroArch more frequently from now on. As the week closed, I wanted to try a few other emulators and games. Dreamcast emulation is absolutely brilliant, and I had hours of fun playing Virtual Tennis. It plays so well and looks fantastic on the 3.5-inch screen. Virtual Boy is a fantastic addition. It's great to get to play a library of games that to date I've not had access to. And what's even better is it feels like I'm playing them on genuine Nintendo hardware. Plus, I don't even need to give myself a headache for the pleasure. PSP, however, wasn't great. Most retro emulation handhelds always seem to include a console that is just a bit too far a stretch for the hardware. And for the RG35X XSP, PSP is that console. Playing Ridge Racer wasn't terrible, but there was significant slowdown. And for the first time on the 35X XSP, I was pulled out of the illusion of the gameplay. The 35X XSP is such a fantastic console from Ambernic, and what I believe to be the best homage console to date. It perfectly captures the look, feel, and magic of the original Game Boy Advance SP, and provides the gameplay to match. Playing Game Boy Advance games on RetroArch with a Game Boy Advance filter is an absolute dream and feels every bit as much as it did on the original GBA SP. Beyond that, the RG35XX SP improves on the Game Boy Advance by providing generations of other consoles, from original Nintendo to Virtual Boy, as well as PS1, Dreamcast, arcade classics, obscure mini handhelds like the Poke Mini, and some PSP thrown in at the end. It also comes with a great battery life, a solid although not intuitive sleep mode, and a screen so good that I no longer feel the need to chase down an expensive AGS 101 anymore. I'm now torn between the 28XX and the 35XX SP as to which is my favorite XX handheld. I think I need to do a 28XX week-long test to find the answer. In the meantime, you can find out all about the 28XX right here.